The United Kingdom's approval today of Pfizer's COVID vaccine dialed up the anticipation, pressures, and questions about vaccines in the U.S. and how the distribution will be handled. William Brangham talks with one of the federal government's leading authorities on making this happen.
Judy, the Pfizer vaccine, which needs ultra-cold storage, is likely to be available in the U.S. later this month, and it will likely go to healthcare workers and then to elderly Americans living in long-term care facilities. The government's program also anticipates offering the vaccine from Moderna later this month. All told, the government says 20 million people could be vaccinated in the U.S. by the end of this year and possibly 100 million by the end of February 2021. Dr. Moncef Slaoui is the chief scientific officer for the government's vaccine program known as Operation Warp Speed, and he joins me now. Dr. Slaoui, very good to have you on the NewsHour. 100 million Americans by the end of February, that seems a remarkably optimistic and ambitious goal.
Well, it is an ambitious goal, and it's a goal that we have been working very hard since the month of May to be able to achieve, frankly. We are, as you know, on the verge of having two vaccines approved, I hope, by the FDA on December 11th or so and December 18th or so, and we can start immunizing. We think we will have 40 million doses of these vaccines in the month of December. That's enough to immunize 20 million people because each individual needs two doses of vaccine. And then we plan to have about 60 million doses on the month of January, and then 100 million doses between these two vaccines in the month of February. And we feel that the plan is achievable, is stretched, is challenging, but is achievable.
It is remarkable that we're even talking about vaccines being developed and rolling out in the same year that we discovered the virus we're trying to vaccinate against. You have said that we could be close to herd immunity in the U.S. by as early as May. How many Americans would likely have to be vaccinated to achieve that goal?
Yes, this is very, very important, frankly, an area of potential concern for everybody involved in public health, in the sense that we need about 75 to 80% of the total population to be immune against the virus for herd immunity to really impact the rest of the population. We will be producing enough vaccine doses by the month of May to cover about 80% of the population. What we don't know, but we really hope that it will happen, is that the vaccine doses will actually be used and people will accept to be immunized. Very, very important. We're working hard, trying to talk to everybody about how we developed this vaccine, how we didn't cut any corner. We took financial risk, we took operational risk, we did not take any scientific or safety risk. We are thrilled that the vaccines are highly efficacious, and we look forward to the reviews totally transparently by independent bodies, independent advisory board, for instance, to the FDA, that we look into the data, discuss the data in public transparently, and then potentially recommend the vaccine for approval.
You're talking about this concern that many people share, that there's a lot of people who are suspicious about vaccines and might not take them even if the data are quite good. What other challenges, apart from that, do you see as challenges in the road ahead?
Well, there are several challenges. First, our plans rely on six vaccines being successful and approved. We have two. We have another two that are completing their phase three trials, probably reading out in January and hopefully approved in late January or early February. They need to be effective. We hope they will be, but you know, we're never sure. We'll know when we know. And then two more that may come in the month of May. Those may have less impact on the first round of immunization, I would say, in the population. The second thing that's need to happen is we are manufacturing this vaccine daily, and every single dose that we produce will be shipped outside. This is very complex manufacturing, and we just reached the industrial scale for manufacturing. Problems could happen. We don't have reasons to believe that they will happen, but having long experience for 30 years producing new vaccines early on. Things happen, reality happens. We may have slippages of time by a week or a day or 2 weeks.
The World Health Organization today cautioned that there may simply not be enough vaccine in the supply chain to head off a major surge this winter, which many people fear. Do you worry that this good news, and it is undeniably good news, about these vaccines might cause some people to loosen up their precautions and think, oh, the end is near, we don't have to worry about masking and distancing and all of those things?
Well, this is a real concern, indeed, because vaccine, even in this country, where unfortunately we are experiencing a major surge, and it could get worse, unfortunately, we will not be able to immunize all the population at once. This is going to happen gradually over the next 5 or 6 months. During that period of time, everyone needs to assume and act as if they were not protected. We need to have our mask, we need to keep our distance, we need to wash our hands, we need to continue being extremely aware of what we're doing and where we are, because even if we are immunized, we may be protected against disease, but we may carry the virus to somebody else. And just, we would show the wrong example. So I think it's a very important point that you raise. It is a concern. I hope everybody will understand. It's a matter of only a few months. So please be patient and be resilient.
All right, Dr. Moncef Slaoui, Chief Scientific Officer for the Operation Warp Speed. Thank you very much for being here.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.